a nation that has businesses that are doing well actually empowers people to spend money in the country, as opposed to stashing their funds in, you know, countries elsewhere, Swiss banks, etc. You're empowered to actually invest in the country because you know you're going to get a positive return on investment. At the end of the day, it really has to be a function of people looking at Ghana and saying, you know, we want to come here because things work here. Policies have to work. Policies have to be fair and functional. The focus cannot only be on international investments coming in or international companies coming in. As the keynote speaker said as well, it's really a function of strengthening the local indigenous companies as well as the multinationals, which have actually, you know, settled here. The critical role of leadership in branding any country doesn't rest only with government. Of course, if there's a critical high-level champion like the presidency or, you know, a designated person in government, that helps because then you have somebody who is actually bringing coherence in implementation or formulation of policy. But there, at the end of the day, it trickles down to business leaders. We cannot shy away when we have to make contributions. I think it's time we moved away from just complaining and actually taking action, volunteering our services actually, and our expertise to be able to work closely with government as well to drive policy and to shape policy. And so I think for me, nationalization is key. We can't lose focus of what the local businesses contribute and the impact of what we do, because at the end of the day, if somebody looks in and says, this is a fine place to do business because the systems work, the judiciary works, the policies work, and it's transparent. And that's how I think together we can grow.